Hello students, I am Dr. B.K. Singh, Professor of Civil Engineering at Ajay Kumar Garg Engineering College, Ghaziabad. So today I will discuss M50 grade mixed design using ordinary Portland cement of 43 grade and fly ash using IS 10262-2019 method. So, concrete may be, we have the following steps. So, first will be stipulations of the proportioning. So, data will be given. So, what are the data is required from the field? So, that must be given, what should be the grade of concrete field condition, exposure condition, types of admixtures, type of cement. So, all this data will be there. We have to collect the material from the site in the laboratory, then we have to go for the test. So, different types of tests will be performed, then you have to calculate the mean target strength, then approximate air content, selection of water cement ratio, selection of water content, calculation of cement and fly ash content, proportion of volume of coarse aggregate and fine aggregate, mix calculations and mix proportioning for trial number 1. So, these are the steps we have to follow. So, here we will be completing in this 25 minutes lecture the whole design here. So, first what will be the data given? So, grade designation will be given, say we have in this particular example I have taken a M50 grade concrete and type of cement 43 grade OPC conforming to IS 269-2015 and type of mineral admixture fly ash conforming to IS 3812 part 1 2013, maximum nominal size of aggregate that is given 20 mm, exposure condition is severe for RCC work and workability is 125 mm for pumping category and exposure condition. Oh, sorry, here I have written this we can discard here. So, already I have taken a exposure condition, severe condition. Okay. Then method of concrete placing. So, by pumping you have to do, degree of supervision is good. So, type of aggregate, crushed angular aggregate is there, chemical etched mixer type. So, super plasticizer, normal type of super plasticizer we have to use. Then after getting the material in the laboratory, we have to perform the test and you have to report. So, like cement, so we got the cement of SCC 43 grade ordinary Portland cement, all the types of testing had been conducted, required test, and that we have to confirm that it is as per the norms of IS 269-2015. So, IS 269-2015 gives all the three grades of specification of all the three grades of cement, like 33 grade, 43 grade or 53 grade, and we have calculated the specific gravity of cement 3.15, which is required, and fly ash also we have collected and tested as per the specification of 3812 part 1 2013. A specific gravity of fly ash we have calculated 2.2 by experiment. Then chemical admixtures I have selected Sika 170, because different brand name admixture are coming and different commercial people are doing, like Phosphorock is there, yeah, Sika is there. So, here I have tried with Sika Met 170, that is conforming to 2103-1999. A specific gravity of fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, and coarse aggregate also two types of coarse aggregate is there, one is 20 mm to 10 mm range and 10 mm to 4.75 mm range. So, both are having the specific gravity of 2.78 because source is same. Then combined specific gravity is also 20 mm is 60% and 10 mm and downside is 40%. So, fine aggregate a specific gravity is 2.68. So, now you see the coarse aggregate, this data is not required, this 2.68 2.80 combined, it will be also 2.78. There is a topographic mistake, so this is also 2.78. So fine aggregate is having a specific gravity of 2.68, and water absorption, so in dry condition it is able to absorb the water of 0.45% for 20 mm size, coarse aggregate 0.55%, and fine aggregate is able to absorb 1% for getting the saturated surface dry condition. Then we have the coarse and fine aggregate are wet, and their total moisture content is 2% and 5% respectively, because that is available. So the free moisture content in coarse and fine aggregate shall be as shown in below. So if you consider the free moisture content here, so this is a 2 is there, and then we have 0.45 plus 0.55 divided 2, so we get 1.5% free moisture content, and similarly for free moisture content, total moisture content minus water absorption, so this is 5 minus 1 equal to 4%. Okay, so that was having 5% water content was having 5% in field. Okay, that is absorption was there. So similarly, sieve analysis data is there. So if you see the sieve analysis data for coarse aggregates, so we have two parts. One is 20 to 10 mm size, and another is 10 to 4.75 mm size. And this is as for table number 7 of IS 20383 2016, that is the latest code. So their proportion, if you see, this is having a 60% of 20 to 10 mm size, and 40% 2 ratio we have, 40% size is 10 to 4.75 mm. And 5 aggregate we have done the sieve analysis, and table from the, if you see the table number 9 of IS 383 2016, so this you have to add table number 9, so you will get grading zone is 2. So these are the given data and test reports. After the test reports, we have to go for the calculation. So first calculation, we have to go for the mean target strength. So mean target strength can be given by this equation, FCK plus 1.65 standard deviation, or F dash CK, FCK into X. So this is given in your IS 20262019. So that you have to take table number here, table number 1. So that is going to give you the value of X, and for M50 grade concrete we have to take 6.5. Okay. And for assumed standard deviation, we have to consider the standard deviation. So M30 to M60 grade concrete we have to take a standard deviation of 5. So S value we have taken 5. And then we have to calculate the target strength for mixed proportioning. So we have just calculated F dash CK equal to, it is a M50 grade concrete. So characteristic strength of F50 grade concrete is 50 MPa, means 50 Newton per mm square. So K value, statistical constant is 1.65, and assumed standard deviation is 5. Because at initial stage we may not be able to have the exact value of a standard deviation. So first trial we have to consider 5, and then after the field trial you can change this standard deviation, you can adjust that. So you can take 58.25 here, and FCK plus X is given 56.5. So out of these two values we have to consider the maximum value. So our mean target strength should be based on 58.25. So approximate air content, so whatever the means we adopt, so depends on the type of coarse aggregate, there will be a entrapped air in the concrete. So for 10 mm it is 1.5, for 20 mm approximately 1% will be the entrapped air. So here we have adopted 1%, this one. So this table has been taken from clause number 5.2, we see the specification. So, once again it is taken from IS 1026. So, all this mixed design is referring to IS 1026-2019. Then based on your mean target strength, so our mean target strength is 58.25 Newton per mm square. So, for that we have a three curve here. So, this curve has also been taken from the same graph. So, here this value is your 58.25, from here you come and take this graph, because this graph is meant for ordinary Portland cement of 43 grade, as well as for PPC and also for granulated GGBF. If the cement is slag cement, also you can take like this table number, graph number 2, curve number 2. So, from here 58.25, you come here, you will get 0.29. So, water cement ratio required from a strength point of view is 0.29. So, water cement ratio is 0.29 from a strength criteria, that you have to take. Okay. So, that you can get a strength of 58.25 Newton per mm square, and characteristic strength you may get 50. Okay. So, that is from a strength criteria, and then you have to consider the durability criteria also. So, if you consider the durability criteria here, so what you are having, our durability condition, exposure condition is severe. So, and our work is RCC work, reinforced cement work. So, for RCC work, if you go here, you have to take minimum 320 kg of cement and 0.45 water cement ratio. Minimum, maximum water cement ratio is maximum 3 water cement ratio. So, cement is nothing but cementitious material. So, if you see here, this is nothing but cementitious material. So, our value is how much? 0.29 from a strength point of strength point of view, we are getting a 0.29, and from durability 0.45. So, our water cement ratio selected 0.25 is less than 0.45. So, hence okay. So, you can adopt this value 0.29. Okay. So, now selection of water content. So, if you see the table 4 of IS 10262-2019, for different size of aggregate. So, as the size of aggregate is increasing, 10 mm, 20 mm, 40 mm, water requirement is reducing. Okay. Water requirement is reducing. Okay. So, here what you are observing here? So, for our nominal maximum size of aggregate is 186. So, 186 is there. This is for a slum value of 25 to 50. So, this is for slum value of, this table has been given for slum value of 20 to 50 mm. But our case, our is pumpable concrete, and also slum requirement is 125 mm. So, if our slum required is 125 mm, so we have to change this value. Okay. So, what is say for 25 to 50 mm slum range, but for increase by about 3% for every additional 25 mm slum. So, our slum is increasing 125. So, you can say 50 plus 25 plus 25 plus 25. So, 3%, 3%, 3%. So, total 9% we have to increase this value, water value. So, water content required is 186. So, just we have increased by 9%. So, our water requirement has come to 202 liter. So, you have to take water requirement equal to, water required equal to 202 liter. So, all this calculation has been done and given here. Okay. Now, so based on trial with super plasticizer, so water content 23.7% there will be reduction is required water. If you are using a 1% of admixture, Sikamet admixture by weight of cement, so 23.76% there is a reduction. So, you have to reduce this amount. So, 202, so if you calculate this amount, so you will get 154 liter. So, water required is 154 liter. Okay. Now, we will go for calculation of cement and fly ash. So, I discussed earlier, now water cement ratio is 0.29. So, here cement 154 is the water and this is the water cement ratio. So, content of water cement ratio is 0.29. So, water content divided by 0.29. So, water content is how much? 154 divided by 0.29. So, you will be getting 531 kilogram per meter cube. So, this much is the cementitious material required. Okay. So, addition of percentage by fly ash depend upon project requirement and quality of fly ash. So, similarly, increase in cementitious material content is also permitted based on trial and experience. So, let us increase 10% of required material. So, here if you see here, let us increase cementitious material content by 10%. So, 531 into 1.10. So, requirement is 58.4. So, roughly you say 584 kg of cementitious material you want, and our water content is 154. So, what is the final water cementitious ratio? What is the final value of water by cementitious material ratio is 150 divided by 584 is 0.264. So, for all that calculation, we will take a water cement ratio of 0.264. Okay. So, fly ash we can take 30%. So, 30% you can assume. So, if you calculate the, then you can calculate the 175 kg per meter cube. Okay. So, what will be the amount of cement? So, this will be nothing but 584 minus 175. So, 409 kg per meter cube. Okay. So, what IS 456 say? You should not use cement, raw cement more than 450 kg per meter cube, because there will be a shrinkage problem and other problem like heat of hydration may be occurring. So, you have to refer clause 8.2.4.2 of IS 456-2000. So, this clause has come because, so this is also within the limit. So, 409 is okay. So, from table number 5 of IS 456, minimum cementitious content for severe exposure condition is 320 kg per meter cube. So, you have to consider durability criteria as per the table number 5. Okay. So, if you refer the table number 5, so that you have to consider. Okay. Then you go for proportion of volume of coarse aggregate and fine aggregate content. Okay. So, as per the table number 5 of IS 10262, this is given here. Suppose for 20 mm size, what is the volume of coarse aggregate? So, our maximum nominal size of aggregate is 20 mm. And what is the grade of zone fine aggregate? That is a zone 2, that we have calculated from sieve analysis, from the test data. Okay. So, how much you are getting? 0.62. So, 0.62 you can take for normal work. So, water cement ratio of 0.520 is 0.62, but this concrete is pumpable. So, if the concrete is pumpable, in that case that you also we have to adjust here also, so that that also you consider. So, this is, so that is for water cement ratio of 0.5. So, this table is for water cement ratio of 0.5, but our water cement ratio is different, that is nothing of 0.264. So, 0.264, what you have to do? You have to take the volume of coarse aggregate is required to be increased to decrease the fine aggregate content. As the water cement ratio is lower by 0.236, so 0.50 minus 0.264. So, you will get about 0.236 value is lower. So, the portion of volume of coarse aggregate is increased by 0.01 for every plus minus 0.05 change in water cement ratio. So, here we have calculated 0.236 is the down. So, you divide by 0.05, so you will get 4.72 times of 0.01. So, if you calculate this, you will get 0.0472. So, you just add, if you see here, so 0.62 plus 0.0472. So, you have to take the increase coarse aggregate, that will be 0.6672. Okay. Similarly, we have to take the corrector proportion of volume equal to 0.672, and if it is a pumpable concrete, then value should be reduced up to 10%. So, this is also has been given in IS 10262. So, this is given in IS 10262 2019. So, if you reduce this, so your requirement will go to 0.60. So, volume of fine aggregate, so will be nothing but total, suppose volume is 1, so 1 minus, so 40% should be fine aggregate means sand, and 60% should be coarse aggregate, that will consist of 20 mm to 10 mm downside plus 10 to 4.75 downside aggregate. Okay. So, now mix calculation, how to go for the mix calculation? So, you know, you take the volume of concrete 1 meter cube, volume of entrapped air is 1% means 0.01 meter cube. So, volume of cement, how to calculate? Mass of cement divided by a specific gravity of cement divided by 1000. So, our cement content is 409, cement specific is 3.15. So, volume of cement you got 0.1298. Similarly, volume of fly ash, you can get mass of fly ash divided by a specific gravity of fly ash divided by 1000, you get 0.0795 meter cube. So, based on the trial, we had kept chemical admixture 1% by weight. So, what is the weight? So 584 divided by 100. So, you will get 5.84 kg, 14. Okay. So, volume of admixture, once again, volume of admixture will be nothing but mass of admixture divided by a specific gravity divided by 1000 will give you 0.0051 meter cube. So, volume of water, so that will be nothing but 154, that will become 1.54 meter cube. Similarly, volume of all in aggregate will be nothing but that will be nothing but 1 meter cube minus entrapped air minus volume of cement, volume of fly ash, volume of admixture and volume of water. So, you will get 0.6216 meter cube will be volume of all in aggregate. So, you have mass of coarse aggregate will be nothing but this F into volume of coarse aggregate. So, similarly, we have divided by a specific gravity of coarse by 1000, so you will get 1167.58. Similarly, mass of fine aggregate can be calculated with the help of a specific gravity. So, we have if this value, this is the volume, then volume of fine aggregate multiplied by a specific gravity multiplied by 1000. So, from volume you can convert to mass with the help of a specific gravity. So, this volume is 0.612. And what is the volume? 0.40. So, 2.6 is the specific gravity of fine aggregate. So, you will get 666.36 kg. So, mixed proportion for trial number 1 is cement is 409 kg, fly is 175 kg, water is 154 kg per meter cube. or you can take in volume also. So fine aggregate 66.36, coarse aggregate 116.76, chemical adsorption 5.84, and free water cement ratio is 0.64 here. But what is here? Our what is here? Because once our concrete is dry condition or wet condition, so it is in wet condition. So we have to adjust the weight of the coarse aggregate, fine aggregate, and water. So this adjustment we are supposed to do it. Okay. So adjustment of water, fine aggregate, and coarse aggregate. Because our coarse aggregate and fine aggregate is wet. So what is the fine aggregate weight? So mass of wet fine aggregate will be nothing but mass of fine aggregate in surface saturated dry condition into 1 plus free surface moisture by 100. Okay. So fine aggregate is having 4% excess water. So this is nothing but 66.36 multiplied by 1. So we have to increase by 4%. So 666.36 multiplied by 1.4, you can get 693 kilogram. So that is that much weight of sand we have to weight because water is also there. Similarly, for coarse aggregate, here also mass of the weight coarse aggregate, then we have to take increase by 1.5%. So that we have calculated earlier. So 1.5% is the excess water. So what should be the weight? So increase this 1.675 by 1.5%. So this will be from 185. So say 185 kg. Okay. So the quantity of this water is required to be subtracted from the calculated water. So how much is the excess here? So 693. Some water content is there in this one. 4%, and this is the actual condition. So 26.64 kg is excess water in 1 meter cube of concrete. Similarly, water content contribution by wet coarse aggregate, you can here you can 185 and 16 saturated, so you are getting 17.4 kg. So requirement for added water becomes 153 is water content. This is the excess water in fine aggregate, and this is the excess water in coarse aggregate. So final water content requirement is 110 kg. So if you see the mix proportion here, so for wet aggregate cement is 409 kg per meter cube, fly ash requirement is 175 kg per meter cube, water to be added 110 kg per meter cube, fine aggregate 693 kg per meter cube, coarse aggregate is 1185 kg per meter cube, chemical admixture is 5.84 kg per meter cube, and free water cement ratio is 0.264. So this is the data for first trial. So whenever we are doing, so by doing the slump test, you can adjust the water content. If the water content requirement is increasing, then you have to increase it also and redesign the things. Okay. That is important, otherwise you may not be able to get the proper workability. So this is the trial one, and by varying the ratio by ±10%, you can go for another two trial. And then you can select the optimize the your mix. Okay. So that way we have completed the design M50 grade concrete using fly ash as well as ordinary Portland cement. So with the help of this, we can design other grade of concrete also. So we have understood the procedure. Okay. Thank you.